And welcome back at 6:53. New movies for the weekend, the best of the bunch, the big screen adaptation of the small screen PBS series, Downton Abbey. Take a look at my Dean's List review.
Tennyson, kind hearts are more than coronets and simple faith than Norman blood.
Will you have enough cliches to get you through the visit?
If not, I'll come to you.
Here's she is my favorite in this. Set 2 years after the popular PBS series ended, the Crowley family and their spunky servants are all back, though as if not even one day has gone by. It's the big screen version of Downton Abbey, a real treat for fans of the series. But this really still makes a lot of sense for those of you who have never seen a single episode. It's a refreshing change of pace at the movies as a civil and refined offering with a twist of drama and a twist of clever humor that's hard to find at the Cineplex. In this movie version, all of the regular series cast members are back, enjoying a peaceful time at the manor when word comes that the King and Queen of England are about to pay an overnight visit, sending everyone into high gear preparing. For fans of the show, it's a nice reunion of the old chaps and chapettes. But even for the newly installed, the smart writing and the very clean movie making here invites you into this special world with such beauty and civility, making you understand what all of the talk and all of the Emmy Awards have been about. Now, there are plenty of subplots here for everyone. It's not overly excessive. The highlight, definitely the incorrigible Dame Maggie Smith as Countess Violet. She's got something to say about everyone and does it in a beautiful, elegant, and such a cutting way. I enjoyed revisiting Downton Abbey. I gave it a Dean's List B+.
All these years I've kept my secrets. But the time has come to face my past.
Not screened in advance for critics. That's never good news. There is Rambo, Last Blood, with Sylvester Stallone in his fifth installment of the franchise. 37 years after it first debuted, it is rated R. And also this weekend at the movies, there's the 37th annual Reeling Film Festival playing at the Landmark Century Theaters, the world's second oldest LGBTQ film festival, running through September 29th with award-winning feature films and videos, documentaries, experimental short films, all coming from all over the world. See reelingfilmfestival.org to get more information. And as always, you can get my weekend movie review grade sent to your phones every Friday just by texting the word Dean to 97999, sponsored by Rossini's romantic comedy, The Barber of Seville, coming to the Lyric Opera September 28th through October 27th. You can learn more at lyricopera.org.